In week one, we discussed selections. I'm going to use my marquee tool and just draw a square selection by holding down the shift key. You will notice I've got feathering options. Without any feathering, you'll have a hard edge between your pixels where this selection meets. So if I go image, adjust, hue saturation, you could also get there by going control or command U, and I desaturate that fully to 100%. If I hit command H, that will show or hide the marching ant selection around it, control or command H. So you can see what's going on, and you could always hit preview to see how it's changing your image by clicking the preview icon there. So there's a hard transition between the pixels there. So I'm going to undo that. I'm going to make another square selection by holding down shift. And this time, I'm going to feather it 450 pixels and hit enter. Now, I'm going to deselect by clicking. If you make a selection, then you click anywhere outside of your selection, you'll lose that selection. Or you could hit command or control D to deselect. So now I'm going to do another square, but this time with 450 pixels. And the selection is not big enough, so I'm going to make it a little larger. And you see the square turn into a circle because when you feather your selection, you got to change the size of it. It's softening the edges, and it's such a large amount that it actually made it a circle. I'm going to hit Control U to bring up my hue saturation. And now you see this, it's so feathered you can barely even see the difference. I'm going to hit Command H to hide my marching ant. And you can see it's very subtle because it's such a small selection and it's feathered so much. When you're collaging or blending images together, it's very crucial to think about the edges of your selection. Do they need to be hard or soft? In nature, there's a lot of fall off of light and shadow, as well as softened edges when things are further away. So please pay attention to your edges when you're manipulating your images. Another way of selecting is through color range. I got there by going select, color range. Let's pretend I want to select just the blue in the sky. And I'm going to click the blue in the sky, and I can add to it using the add eyedropper to make sure I get all of the image. You can change your selection preview down here, either by grayscale, and I can see that I missed these pixels up here. But now you see you're starting to get some of that. So I'm going to undo that by clicking the minus. Now that's looking pretty usable. Let me see if I can get... You could also change the strength of it by adjusting the fuzziness. Let me increase it a little bit, and I'll slide down the range. I'm going to use this next part to demonstrate how to remove that. So I'm going to hit OK. And remember, we've got pixels down here that were selected. To subtract from your selection, you hold down Alt or Option. So I'm holding down Alt, and it deselected all the pixels I'm going over. Now up here, I see I missed some pixels. To add to your selection, you click and drag and hold down Shift. So holding down Shift will add pixels to your selection in case I missed any of these, and holding down Alt or Option will subtract pixels from your selection. So you can always go in before you make your changes and do that. So now if I hit Control U or Command U to bring up my saturation, I'm going to hit Command H to hide the edges. You can see what was and was not affected based off of that color selection.